Earthbound on the Super Nintendo is a video game featuring world's most sought confusion, but relatable humor and identical references and a bold twist. Irrelevance to most suffering battle system and laboring effort. It racks up the difficulty spike in a challenging experience with a great storyline and wacky and sad chiptune music. The game is very different. It plays like one. First, you're registering your name in a town called Onit, and now you're in some other town with trauma, with Pokey and other villains trying to mess up your life. Adept at credential blast of great dialogue and prosodic measurements of fun. Great science for history lessons, perpetrator, gameplay with nifty abilities and names, and funny zooming experience that does right well. The bosses are a lunch till a thirsty of nature name, said Bundling Robots. It's like sleeping walking into a tycoon dream of surprises with discipline. It's a crafty artistic purpose, and it soothes up relaxation and frustration to beat the Psy walking game. Not even that, there's so many levels and worlds to explore for a SNES classic gem. The cycle abilities in this game is well done into consideration. One of the greatest vision of storytelling history, it made me feel like I was in the game and fighting for my replayable life. This game has weird and strange things all over it, to the enemies and audacious goals. It's a game with a specific type, a guilty experience to play for many hours and enjoy this futuristic and dreamy world. It's a Reaper City of balanced difficulty and well-riddled fun. The music is what makes this game a classic. Some tunes are wacky, some tunes are gold mines. Some tunes will make you relax like you're in a hotel luxury. Some are just plain altitude creepy. But what makes this game a number one hit in my big old library and the brutal dream sensation? It takes you into a faraway place. It's finding the true essence of beauty and charm in your soothable heart. I give this game a 10/10. Not for the gameplay, storyline, music, but what makes this game creative and different. It replaces Super Mario Bros. And Zelda Link to the Past, plus Metroid and other video game franchises, into something new and unique. That's why it gets a 10.0. And now I realize why this game is one of the top 3 RPGs in SNES history. And I agree fully. Love the Burrito Master.